In this video, we are going to learn how to fix a common issue when swapping variants. Moreover, we are going to learn how to extend our purple variant set and add more variants to it, such as blue color. If you're interested to see how we built our variants, you can watch our part 1 and part 2 video tutorials. Once we build our purple and blue variants, we can easily switch them without actually using variables. Step 1. As you can see, even though we managed to switch the colors correctly, the percentage bar is not being displayed correctly as we switch to the dark mode. This issue can be resolved if you're using variables, but for the purpose of this video, we are not going to use variables at all. We want to assume that everyone's using a free version. So let's just go ahead in the components. And if we take a look at the right side here, we see we only are displaying 11 variants and it's only a light version. So in order for us to expand that, we have to basically move the progress to the right side, also expand that a little bit and select all the variants, which is 11 at the moment, hold option and duplicate them, and then basically releasing them. Step 2. As soon as you release them, make sure not to touch any of the variant properties because we do want to have them identical. We just want to add additional variant, which means we need to click on the master one, go to the properties, add another variant, and then just rename this to light. And here we see that our variant light is added. So we would just click and drag this to the top. And now we need to make this dark and give it true. So let's just go ahead, select all of them, scroll down to the fill section. Here it is using light purple 60. So we just need to search dark version of it. And the closest one is the dark 80. And also for the light purple 90, we need to search for the dark version. And we are going to use the 40. So right now you see that we managed to flip the colors. All we have to do is select it one more time, go all the way up to the variant section. Since we added a new variant property, we need to make sure that the light for this one is set to false and the light version for this one is set to true. Step 3. By doing that, we have in total 22 variants. If I select all of them on the left side, if I scroll up, all of them are set to true with different variants in terms of percentage. And if I select all the 11s on the right side, they're all set to false on the light version and they all have different percentage values, which means now if I go ahead and select my progress, I have it as light, which is again, the first one is as light, which is true. The second one, however, if I select the middle one, the bar chart with percentage, it is not being displayed correctly. So what I need to do is simply delete that, click on the variant, which is set as light true, and then here we see that plus icon, so I can add another variant, drag it out. In terms of the light value, I would rename this to false because I do want to have this as dark version. And as soon as I rename this to false, all I have to do is select the new bar chart with percentage and make sure the light is set off. Previously we didn't have this new property, so as soon as we turn this off, now I can simply go and select the parent auto layout and just switch the colors from light to dark, which is 15, and also from text all the way to 100%. So now if I visit the demo page here, we managed to switch them, and as you can see, the switching was off. So if I go ahead and delete that, hold option and try to drag it one more time, press return on my keyboard, now I can safely switch this from light to dark, and you see the values are all preserved, the colors are all changed correctly, and the bar chart is being displayed correctly as well. Step 4. Since we successfully managed to create a dark and light version of our progress bar using a purple color, as you can see on the right hand side, we actually categorize them based on purple, background, and text. What we can do right now is actually reorganize this and try to add different themes, as well as preserving the light and dark version. So for the light version, we are not going to change the text color and the background color. However, for the dark version, we do want to change the color of the background. So instead of having background under the dark, what we can do is click and drag this under purple, because the background color for the dark version is going to be changed according to the theme that we choose. But the background color and the text for the light version is not going to change. It's always going to stay light. So right now, if I collapse everything, on the light, we have purple, background, and text. And under dark, we have purple and text. Text is going to always be the same. However, under purple, we have the foreground and background color. And then we have two colors and an additional background color. If you don't want to nest them, you can simply click and drag this out. This way, you keep everything under one folder. So if I go ahead and visit my components, now I need to expand this again one more time. Here I have my bar charts and I would just simply drag them, and then I would just zoom in here, select all of them, which is 22 variants, hold alt and drag them out, and I'm going to leave them as is. And right now we want to use another color. In this example, this is going to be the dark version. version of our colors, and this is going to be light version, and the bottom half is going to be a different color. Let me add a bit of a space so we understand the actual variants. So here I would just drag it a little bit more so we understand that these are the bottom colors. There we go. Now what we need to do is, let's say we want to use color, we would navigate to the properties, add the plus, add another variant. Let's just go ahead and type purple. And then we can click and drag this all the way to the top. And as you can see, the 22 variables up top, which are being purple, we can select them and then give this as true. And the 22 variables at the bottom, we are going to recolor them. So we would make sure that the purple is selected as false. Step 5. So now it's time for us to recolor it. So in order for us to test one out, I would just click and drag this one out holding option. And I would try to scroll down. Here we have the colors selected for us, and instead of 60, I would just detach that, and then I'll make sure to go with blue, for example, instead of green. So let's just go ahead and choose 210. And as soon as I do that, you see that the color is changed because we are using HSL colors. Also, I would go ahead and detach the other one and select that, switch that to 210, and I'm happy with the colors. So I need to add these to the color styles using the naming convention that I provided. So if I click outside here, you see that we have light purple 60 and 90. We would exactly repeat the same, which means we would scroll down, click on this, click plus, go to the style, and then just type light slash blue slash 60. And for the second one, we would just write light blue 90 and then create the styles. And for the dark version, let me just go ahead and drag one out. In this example, I'll drag the other one. Here we have 80 and 40. So we would detach that, change that to 210 on the hue. Also change that to 210 on the hue as well, and repeat the same process. And instead of actually having this as light version, we would just rename this to dark. So it would be dark slash blue slash 80, create the style, and then dark blue 40, create the style as well. So we're happy with the colors. All we need to do is basically apply that to these. And if I take a look at the right side, we see that a new folder is created for us, which is blue, and we added these two colors. So let's just go ahead and delete these sample ones. And for the dark version, I would scroll all the way up, making sure that it is purple set to false and light set to false. And now I would scroll down and make sure I select dark blue 80 and also dark blue 40. So here I would just go and search for dark and then blue. Here I would select 80 and then dark blue and I would select 40. There we go. And now for the other one, I would make sure to filter by light blue and then select 60 and then also light blue and select the 90. Now if I go ahead and try to test this here on the instance, we can scroll all the way up. Now we have another property which is called purple. Here we have purple. We can actually toggle this between purple and blue, and we have light and dark, which we can toggle between light purple or blue purple. So we're happy with this. That means we can actually toggle between light and dark theme and between also blue and purple theme. Finally, we have to go to the progress and add four more properties. Again, we would click on the progress, drag it out, select these two, click plus to add two more variants. Here I would just try to drag them out. And the only additional color that we need to add is the purple. So here under the background purple, we would just detach that and choose 210 for blue. And then once we choose 210 for blue, we would add that to our library, which is dark blue 15, and then create the style. Again, if I close that, we don't want to change the background color and the text color for the light version. We only want to change it for the dark version. Now all I have to do is basically zoom in, select the bar chart percentage, go all the way up, making sure that the purple is off and the light is off because we're using the dark version of blue. And for the top one, I would select that, making sure the purple is off. However, the light version is on because we want to use the light version of blue. Now I'm happy with this. All I have to do is now go to the progress, add another property, which is called purple. So here, variants, I would rename this to purple and I would click and drag it to the top. And I have to make sure I select both of the purples and give them the value of true. Select both of the blues and give them the value of false. Also, if I click on my progress, I notice that my light version has four values and that is incorrect. I have to make sure I fix that as well. So if I click on the first one, the light version is true, which is correct. If I click on the second one, the light version is false. That is correct. Now I need to click on my blue and I see that the light is set to a different value. So all I have to do is making sure I set it to true because we're using a light version of the blue. And I will click on the other one, which is dark. So I'll make sure that the light version is set to false. So by doing that, if I now click on my progress, it is working as expected. Now, if I go to my demo, if I zoom out, try to duplicate these all the way to the other side. Now, if I press return on my keyboard, all I have to do is turn off purple. If I do that, there we go. I have now a blue theme created. Not only I preserved the value, I managed to create multiple themes, which means I managed to create a dark and light version theme. on two colors, which is the purple color and the blue color. Also, if I hover over all of this, they are being responsive as well. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more design tips and tutorials. Let me know what you think in the comments down below.